Okay, so we're gonna start with latex over my eye. So I'm gonna take a couple of paper towels and layer them on top of each other and just stick them down with latex to make sure my eye is covered and safe to put makeup over and all that stuff. Now I'm just gonna start building up a cotton ball wall around my eye. That way I can start building up to create an eye socket. Make sure you blend the edges, that way it blends seamlessly into the skin. Once finished with the eye socket, I'm just going to start blending red eyeshadow and smearing it down my face. Now to make the weird growths on the side of the face, I'm going to take tinfoil that I molded before the video and stick it down with latex and just attach it to my face using latex and cotton balls. And you can bend these however you want afterwards, but just kind of stick them down to get that general idea. And I'm just gonna repeat that using the same process multiple times all over wherever you want on your face. Now I'm going to use that same method with the cotton and latex and shape my nose to give it a more skeletal appearance to help further the transformation of human to crank. Taking a mixture of red, brown, and black, I'm gonna go in and shade the nostrils and around the cotton and latex to further enhance the way my nose looks as far as making it more skeleton-like. Now I'm going to take some browns, reds, and blacks and go ahead and start filling in the eye socket to create a hollow black void where your eye would have. Now you're going to take a foundation in your color and go over all your tinfoil and set it with a powder to match your skin. Then I'm going to add some definition by taking reds, browns, and blacks and going along those growths and going down the neck. And now taking blue, reds, greens, and yellows, I'm going to create veins all along my neck. I'm using grease paints for this, but you can use eyeshadows or whatever you have on hand. Make sure to keep these very sporadic and almost branch-like or almost like cracks. I'm also going to use those paints at the base of all of my growths to make them look like they're actually coming out of the skin and just all around infected. Also, make sure to keep your neck involved with your look and take those veins in those colors all down the neck if you can. I also liked having veins coming down from underneath my eyes as well to kind of further that irritation and almost like sleepless. Like, so that worked really well for me. I also went with those grease paints and took them along the growths as well to kind of spread the color and make everything match. Now I'm just stippling those grease paints all around the face to make my face look dirty. I'm taking browns this time and just doing that now. I also decided to shade along my collarbone and my neck to make myself look thinner to the point where it's almost an unhealthy amount of thin. And now I'm just taking fake blood and going in that eye socket, down my mouth, on my nose, just to kind of bring a gorier aspect to this look. My blood is mouth safe, but please, 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 if you're using the stuff that's not safe to use around your mouth, be extra careful. I went in with some black grease paint around the mouth to bring in the black blood aspect from the movie, and I'm topping that off with some mouth safe blood as well. Now I'm taking a booty ton of hairspray and just running it through my hair and teasing it. And guys, don't ever brush through your hair after you do this. Take a shower. It hurts. Trust me. And now you're looking cranktastic and are ready to take on the day. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and stick around the ghost town for more videos. Bye!